Right, in the Kimmage clay, this is the Pliosaur. This is the largest carnivorous reptile that lived during this sort of time. As you can see here, we got a 2 meter long lower jaw one, and that's not the largest they grew to. Certainly we've got evidence, especially from isolated teeth that have been pushed out, evidence they had sort of skulls up to 3 meters long, which really is immense. And I think in the Natural History Museum, from the clothing, which is a little bit sequence older than the Kimmage clay, we photographed a Pliosaur tooth that measured 16 inches long, including the root. So they are fearsome sort of creatures. And the good thing in the Kimmage here, they've got very distinctive teeth, sub-triangular teeth, that actually when they bite into another reptile and you find the isolated bones, you actually prove beyond doubt that the Pliosaur was the predator. Now, whether they probably caught their prey live, but also they were scavengers, opportunist feeders. And whether they were solitary or they swam in packs, we don't know. But that's, as I say, the most exciting sort of predator we've got in the Kimmeridge and seas. As we come up through time, of course, getting into the Cretaceous, you get Mosasaurs, which are rather like a Komodo dragon in a way, but they swam the seas. Now, they're pretty fearsome creatures as well. So their body is quite long with a sort of tail, four sort of flippers, and they're dead, and they got a, as I say, a lizard-like skull, but pretty big. Some of these things could be sort of again, I think 9-10 meters long, if I'm correct. And the other thing is with them is that not only, say, on their skull and jaw, they've got a row of teeth like this one's got, but at the back of it, it's got another plate with another row of teeth to actually make sure that whatever's in its jaws and going down its throat is going one way. And they were described as, probably a lot of people have done research and think they were the most fearsome sort of predators of all. And there's still some debate about that, because again, mosasaurs are fairly common. Pliosaurs are not, so we've not really got a true sort of a number of reptiles from the Kimmeridge to actually say whether they're the most fearsome creatures and what size they ever grew to. And then, of course, other big predators, you get the sharks, and of course, everyone seems to know what Megalodon is. It's a huge, great shark with teeth. They're immense, feeding on, I think, on whales. And some of those teeth could be as big as this. They were huge, great things. And don't really know a lot about them, but they're reputed to be some of the most fearsome sort of fish of all, really. But again, they're not a sort of reptile, whereas the mosasaurs and the pliosaurs were air-breathing reptiles. So there's some difference. And sharks were probably feeding, like I said, probably on whales and stuff like that, where these were feeding on, same with mosasaurs, anything, but these were primarily feeding on other reptiles, which you've got the evidence to support. Okay, so crocodiles, again in the Kimmeridgian seas, we do get very large crocodiles. So we get these metarhynchid crocodiles, which are different to the crocodiles that you get today and in those times. In the difference is really, they had smooth skins, no bony plates like you see with crocodiles now, smooth skins and a tail with a tail fluke. We know that because we found the fossil record of that, but its front limbs are actually not like a sort of crocodile. They develop more like an ichthyosaur. They've got these sort of, if anyone knows what an ichthyosaur, these bony sort of, composed of various little bones to make a broad flipper. And some of these things grew extremely large. We've got in the collection here, I think, probably two new species of metarhynchid. Now, we know with these, some specifically were feeding on fish, because again, with their teeth, they're just like a pair of scissors. We know that they're ideal for shearing in a sort of fish. And the bigger ones had really big, robust teeth. But again, we got evidence of one which had a 52-inch long mandible, which is getting pretty big. And there are, again, remains of, just small remains of even bigger ones than that. But we've only got fragmentary remains to sort of give us that indication that there were much bigger sort of crocodiles in the Kimmeridge Sea. And I know in the fossil record, crocodiles are probably the most common reptile you find, but in the Kimmeridge Seas, they're not. They really aren't. So anything we find is pretty scientifically important. And what we've got in the collection is just, as I say, a few large teeth to indicate some of these were massive. Right, Predator X, unfortunately for the kids, everyone says, they come in and they say, either, is this Predator X, or is this Liopleurodon? And it's neither. Predator X is a pliosaur that was found in Svalbard, that's an archipelago of islands that's actually owned by Norway in the Arctic Circle. And Predator X came from there, but unfortunately, it's been overhyped. In other words, it's been laid down and preserved, but it's been in permafrost. And of course, with permafrost during the summer months, you get the melting. And then in the winter months, you get the freezing. What's happened? All the bones of that pliosaur are shattered into thousands of bits. And they made a statement that this was the largest pliosaur that's ever been found. Well, I don't think that's correct. I think the only largest pliosaur we've got to date, which is reasonably complete, is the one in Dorset Museum, and that skull and jaw is about nearly 2.5 meters long. So that's the biggest one, I would say. So Liopleurodon, again, is a name for, again, pliosaurs, which these names change all the time. So this pliosaur is called Pliosaurus, and that's what the name we give all the pliosaurs, because at the moment no one's really got a hold on what the species are, or the different species. Now, interestingly, in the 60s, a guy did his PhD on pliosaurs. And if you can see here, this is what we call the symphysis from here onwards. And what he said, he did a tooth count. So here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. And then another pliosaur he found probably only had 5. Now, there is a hell of a difference, but no one's really revised this. So there's still some argument. Are they all the same? I don't think they are, because this pliosaur mandible is really gracile. Some of them are very broad-snouted. And then the biggest one that's been actually the mandible, the biggest one you'll see, is in the Oxford University Museum, but it's been restored immensely, because in those days, anyone had the biggest pliosaur had the biggest kudos, or the most kudos. So this guy had stretched it out. But it's certainly a big pliosaur. Certainly probably bigger than the one that's in Dorchester. But it's been highly crushed as well. So it's not a lot to go on, really.